To my live stream of the Raiders. I just signed a Patrick Mahomes from the Chiefs because I don't think AJ Manuel is getting the job done. So, I got him and he's gonna be the starter until Jamarcus Russell gets back. So that's good. So that's gonna happen. He's gonna be starting against the Titans. That's pretty much all we did, and then we activated Antonio Hamilton because we got a lot of injuries right now for our cornerbacks, so we're in deep shit. That's why we lost our last game. And Patrick Mahomes is 78 overall. That's crazy. And he's not that fast. That's fucking weird, but okay. Strange. He's usually faster than I thought. I guess not. Okay, so so we're gonna get this thing started real soon. Seth Roberts needs to play more. Okay, there we go. Get this thing started. Gotta play the Titans. And now these obviously schedules are not accurate because this is 2016. So every Madden they make, it's always a year behind. The schedules, that is. Players, you can always update the rosters and shit, but yeah. The schedules are gonna be the same. Yeah, but that's what's going on right now. Let's see how Patrick Mahomes does. Should be interesting. He's a lot faster than they put him as, which is weird. So we'll see how he does. Has a 78 overall. Maybe his acceleration is like 80 or 90. So we'll see in a second. Falcons, that was a game, shitty game. We should have won that, but yeah, it was not good. We should have won that game. Our defense just didn't come to play on that, and it cost us the game.
Hello, everybody. I'm Larry Ridley, and
we welcome all of you to Nissan Stadium on the banks of the Cumberland River in downtown Nashville, Tennessee. Today, it's week 3, and we've got a good one in store between the Oakland Raiders and the Tennessee Titans. And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line. So here comes the Raiders offense now onto the field. And they will be led out by a young man making his first NFL start.
See how Patrick does, baby. Looks like a beast.
They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. Finding his safety valve here. That's
complete. Washington.
And he'll get this up past the 25 before he's out of bounds. So they complete the pass, and now they face a second down.
That Mahomes is like black, not like white, like they show him as of right now. Yes, he is.
DeAndre Washington, his first carry. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. 7 yards there, good enough to move the sticks.
Any team that runs the toss and runs it successfully, that means they win the battle on the edges. That means you seal the edge in order to let your back get to the corner. They got it done there for a very nice game.
Now back to throw. Finds
Roberts.
Left Roberts. Side. That throw good for 4. It's second down.
A look at the defensive starters for Tennessee.
When Brian Arakpo was born, there was no doubt that with that name, he was going to be a defensive player and a good one. He knows how to get to quarterbacks.
From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. He's got time. Now he's forced out left. He juked him. And to the 42-yard line here and brought down there. It'll be a gain of four, and it'll be third down. He'll look to throw. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. It's a gain of just a couple there, but it's enough to get him the first.
And Brandon, from our time in college football, where receivers weren't running the traditional NFL route tree, one thing they did learn, find open areas, find soft spots, and set up and catch the ball. And I think we just saw that there.
Yeah, we saw that indeed, picking up the first.
Good job,
he'll be
Washington.
Taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory. And the pocket's been protected pretty good here so far on the opening drive.
We always talk about confidence in runners and catchers and quarterbacks. How about the protection detail? They're not allowing anyone near the guy throwing the football.
He'll drop to throw, and that'll be incomplete. Intended that time for Cooper. That'll bring up second down. And, Charles, we get a look here at the key inactives, and I tell you what, a big list for being this early in the season.
If there's any silver lining at all, you're hoping you can get these guys back, and now you'll play well down the stretch with them.
God damn it.
But what you're also hoping is that the guys who have to play for them, the next man up mentality kicks in, and those guys take care of business.
Now they're coming up on play number 8 of this opening drive, but they're looking at a third and long. Again, he'll drop to throw. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36. Give him 9 on the play, and that's going to make it fourth down. And a good sign for them right now to have their young quarterback looking confident on the opening drive.
Now, we haven't met a young quarterback, a veteran quarterback, it doesn't matter. We haven't met a quarterback yet that doesn't tell us he's confident about his abilities, right?
That's true.
But when you're young, it's really important to get off to a
good start. Oh, look at Washington. DeAndre Washington.
All the way in. Touchdown.
Wow.
Oakland.
That was good.
DeAndre Washington with his first career NFL touchdown. And the Raiders have taken the early lead.
That was pretty good.
And that moment we just saw, always so special for any rookie, the first touchdown of his career.
And there's nothing like anticipation.
Good job, DeAndre.
You know he's been dreaming about it, thinking about it. It's been a part of every bit of his being. And finally, it gets done.
That
he's
was
gotta
pretty
feel
good.
Great right
you
now.
Guys saw
Let's
that.
Field it at the 2.
Ooh,
and he's up
damn.
Past the 20 to the
Helicopter.
22-yard line. So out comes this offense to take over for the first
Who's
time.
That?
And they're led out by their veteran quarterback
Matt
in
Castle?
His 12th season now out of USC. It's Matt Castle.
He's been a backup, and then when pressed into duty, he's been a starter in the NFL. I still remember his debut when he was with the New England Patriots. Tom Brady gets hurt, and Matt Castle takes over for the season and leads his team to an 11-5 record. And somehow, that team didn't make the playoffs.
Shalique Calhoun.
Down he goes. It's the rookie from Michigan State, Shalique Calhoun, in there to drop him. And that will go into the books as the first sack of his young NFL career.
Well, so much for setting the tone of the drive offensively. Giving up a big sack that loses that kind of yardage, not a great start.
And a nice run to get this up over
the 20-yard line.
You guys
can't give up 10 yards.
Pick up of 10 yards.
Sack of 10 yards.
And
give up 10 yards.
Make it third down
on a run play.
Well, in 2016
on a
in
run
Tennessee,
play, you can't
DeMarco
do that.
Murray,
so inconsistent.
We're going to find out if it was style, scheme, does he still have it or not. He thinks he's going to be more comfortable with the Titans.
Yeah, because that fall off last year, 2014, over 1,800 yards, 392 carries.
One of the best seasons running the football that we've seen in recent
and
years.
So here
him.
We go, first and 10 now. He's such a good route runner, shows it there on third down, very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times because he can trust you being in the right spot, and they connected there and picked up a first down.
7 yards to go on second down. play-action fake. They'll look to throw. He's got time in the pocket. Over the middle, Sharp's got it complete. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35.
In recent years, the slot receivers really gained stature in the NFL because they can do so many things. Yes, they can line up wide like your normal wide receiver, but to have that kind of courage and toughness to run routes in the middle of the field and become dependable targets for their quarterbacks and move the sticks, those guys are worth their weight in gold.
That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down.
Brandon, that play ended so fast, it's almost as if the quarterback handed it to the runner and the tackler was there right away for a loss of yardage.
Now Castle.
That's oh my fucking god.
And he carries seriously all the way down to the nine. Wow. A very solid gain of 27.
Jesus fucking Christ.
And the next snap coming inside the red zone here. They'll try to run for it with Henry. Looking for a seam, but finding none. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Now, I can't imagine any celebrations being any bigger than your first NFL touchdown. God. And this rookie running back is still seeking his. He's not going to get it on that play.
Back up, bitch.
Here's Castle, fighting through, and the hit jarred loose. It's incomplete. Quickly now, the starting 11 for the Oakland defense.
Sean Smith is absolutely the prototype of what they call the long corner. Tall, plenty of length in his arms, and the ability to bat away passes.
Stop him for only three that time, and that'll bring up fourth down.
They didn't get the first down, but I have to say, I do like the call. I like what they were trying to do. Try to hit your receiver on the run and see if he can pick it up. Keep it on his feet, get a little rack yardage.
Yeah, but a nice job defensively to get to him and keep him short of the first.
That cast is garbage, guys. Come on now.
11-play drive.
That's a lot of offense to run to only get 3 points, but they'll take them. Anytime you can put anything on the board, you run to your sideline somewhat happy.
This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. And now Oakland ready to take the field. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at
you.
They're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go-around. 10 yards still left on second down.
Well, partner, I guess that answers the question about whether they're going to sit on it or not.
God damn.
Now we'll see if they try that again.
Yeah, I think what we find on plays like that, when you take that shot, if you're unsuccessful, then you go way more conservative to finish the half, you know? I think that's the way they'll go. Really nice play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball, but for the guys on the offensive line, they're doing a nice job trying to protect their passer. But when a guy hops in the air and goes airborne to try to knock one away, it's difficult because you can't reach out and grab him. That'd be a holding penalty. So all you're trying to do is make some type of a play on him, make some type of contact to try and get his arms out of the sky.
On now, the fifth-year man, Marquette King, to kick it away. Ready to go now in the second quarter. Brandon Gaudin, Charles Davis. It's the Raiders in possession of the football, but likely not for long as they're in punt formation to kick it away. And this is away. It's a high kick, and he got all of it. And this one hits at the one, continues on into the end zone for a touchback. And here comes Tennessee as they get set to take the field. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3-point
kicker.
Exactly. He put it through the post. That's going to help him in contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that helped him in contract time. You could have kicked that one through.
I don't know about that.
Toe bash.
I don't know about
toe
that.
Toe bashed it.
Super toe.
Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. Looking middle, and that's complete.
Hang on.
And now the rookie's free. Touchdown, Titans. A big play there with his first career NFL touchdown. And the Titans have taken the lead. So that's the rookie's first trip to the end zone, and I think it's safe to say one he'll always remember.
Oh, without a doubt, that one is going to be imprinted forever. And nowadays, we're seeing rookies make a greater impact at that position at receiver than ever before, I think mainly because of the sheer volume of footballs that they catch in college.
This will be taken about the 12. And good starting field position. He'll get this one all the way up to about the 35-yard line. The Raiders offense now, they trot back out, and they're coming off a three and out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
Oh, my God. Are you kidding me?
Realize it hasn't worked so well.
Are you fucking serious?
Maybe try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players, and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the
collarbone
area.
What the fuck, man? This is retarded.
On second down, Washington. And he stopped
him. How'd everybody get hurt?
No gain on the play, and it's going to bring up a third down. Off the corner. Where'd he come from? Well, I guess he came off the corner, but really nice play.
I like when you're able to pose a question and answer it at the same time. That's exactly where he came from, but it's not something that you normally see. Most of the time, we're thinking about those guys covering pass catchers. In this case, he was a big factor in a run game, no gain. Now, that definitely hurts because the mindset is getting a three and out there, and they don't get it done. They give up the scramble and a pickup for a first down.
Come on, Johnny.
They'll look to throw now on first down. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And he'll be brought down, it looks like, right at the 40. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
Shoulder tear.
Well, the coaches mentioned they weren't as concerned about big play offense. They thought they could get some shorter, quicker stuff and be consistent.
Wow,
that's kind of what they showed there.
What they saw in preparation, what they saw in film, is a defense that likes to get out fast in terms of coverage, meaning they either bail out or they give them a lot of space to throw the underneath stuff, so they decide to take advantage of it.
Everybody that is good at getting hurt. What the fuck do I even do now? Seriously?
And I count six defensive backs out there.
Timing's crucial in any route thrown, but when you throw an out, so many things are going through the mind of the receiver.
I'm so nervous. I don't know what to do. I'm going to put Mickens in. I need to put him in, I think. I'm running out of people. Seth doesn't really do much. Hey, Cordell Patterson.
Coming it up with the quarterback. Are my feet going to get down inbounds? On that play, all those things going through his head.
All people, might have Cooper's going to get hurt.
Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. They'll look to throw here on first down. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. Jared Cook, the tight end, was the target. And that'll bring up second down.
When defenses get to the quarterback,
guys, please
quickly,
comment what you think that Cooper, you guys got hurt. What do I do?
Fast, but fast enough that he had no time to look downfield and set himself to throw the ball. And as he tried to do that, he was hit and it forced an incompletion.
Only 3 yards on the catch.
That's
it's third
good.
Down. This will be the eighth play of the drive. It's third and seven.
But it appears that they read man defense and went to the out route. And what you have to do on that one is the receiver's got to make sure he works the defender towards the middle of the field.
A fight for the football, and it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. The Titans offense now, they work their way back onto the field. And that recipe on their last drive that resulted in the touchdown looked pretty good, so they'll be hoping to do that once more.
And it takes me back to when we sat with the offensive coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan and thought there were some holes in the defense, and they exploited them the last time out. Let's see if they can come back and put together a similar drive.
And we'll see if they can do just that. That was second down long for Murray. It's a loss of four. Now third
down. Is
that
not a safety? Good job, TJ.
The expression, don't blink, you might miss something, certainly applied. That was fast. Defense diagnosed the play, and it was over in a heartbeat.
On third down, Murray.
Are you fucking kidding me?
How
do you not get a safety? Are you fucking serious?
He did well to get him 8 yards, but it's still going to mean a call to the punt team on fourth down. Here's Brett Kern now, as his first punt will come from inside his own end zone.
Safety and extra points. We're doing good. That's a shitty punt. Take that shit.
It's fielded at the 45.
Good job, Nathan. That was a good return.
Breaking that officially. Give him 15.
Now
the Raiders will have
good.
A short field to work with as they take over. And now Oakland ready to take the field. Looked like they had something going last drive. Then the interception happened. Will they recover?
The memory they need to keep with them is that they did have something going. They were moving the ball on offense, had a nice sequence going. Don't worry about the other part. You can't get that back. Let's go back to what you were doing well before.
I thought you were going to say they need to have no memory, but remember the good part, forget the bad.
I like that even better.
They'll set up to throw. He'll buy some time right. And an alley to run. 2 minutes to play here in the first half. Back to Tennessee after this.
Wow, these fucking cheaters.
Back now, as I search for my cue card here, there we go. Coming up at halftime, Larry Ridley will join us from Orlando. He'll have highlights and analysis from our first half of play.
Well read.
Well, thank you.
Oh, my God.
So the incomplete pass brings up second down.
It was open.
Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. Buying time to his left. Throwing left side here, and it's complete. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down. Defense thinking pass. They've got the nickel set out on third and six. Now they'll throw here out of the gun. Dancing to his left. And he fires one, but incomplete.
What the fuck was that to? I don't know who the fuck that was to.
Now on fourth down, Jack Del Rio's going to send on the field goal unit. On the left hash mark, this is a 38-yard attempt. And his kick here is good. And that will knot us up at 10.
Latavius Murray.
So a good kick there, and they finish off the drive with 3.
Damn.
And that should be the goal for an offense. Finish each drive with points. So that's a nice job there to come away with at least something.
And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Here's the Titan offense now as they make their way back onto the field.
The Browns should have got Patrick Mahomes. That would have been good.
They'll try and start this drive in the air. Quick throw that's complete on the inside slam. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the
ooh.
Football and get the quarterback a really
ooh.
Nice target.
It'll go as a gain of 6 that time, and it moves the chains as well. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. Now Castle. Surveying the field. And this one caught by Delaney Walker.
Oh, he's hurt. Uh-oh. That sucks. Amaro, he's decent.
Here's Castle. Sideline throw, it's complete. And a nice job there of keeping the toes inbounds.
3 inches, oh man.
And quickly, they get to the line. On third and short, they'll try and pick it up through the air. And incomplete, he had nowhere to throw, so he just tossed it away.
He's got a punt.
But that brings up fourth.
He should punt,
at least. I have to say, that was a surprise call on third and inches. I thought they'd try and run the football there, but you got to believe they thought they'd surprise the defense and pick up something downfield, but that one goes incomplete.
You better fucking fake it, I'm about to say. Well, that's a shitty punt.
This will be taken at the 10.
Well, good fucking blocking, you fucking idiot.
Give him just 1 yard
wow.
On the return.
You're such
and
a good blocker.
The Raider drive will start from deep in their own territory with a first and 10. And now Oakland ready to take
the field.
Saw
that shit.
Now the ball backed way up, so thinking with this amount of time on the clock, probably
idiot.
Just sit on it.
Let him go past you, not blocking.
Go to the lockers.
Yeah, I don't think you want to overthink it in this situation. Either side of the ball. Just go ahead and finish up the half and get on out and talk about it.
He was trying to get it to Michael Crabtree there. And it's second down. And you really can't pin that one on the quarterback, Charles. The O-line, they've got to protect
them. And they know it. That's their meal ticket. They want to take care of the big guy behind them. In this case, they let him down.
A 50-50 ball here, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Logan Ryan. And they take over. They'll set up shop at the 46-yard line. The Titans offense now, they get ready to do battle again here. And this is a spot late in the clock near midfield, though. Maybe take a couple chances, see if you get in field goal range.
You do that if you have trust, and this should be a position now for the great ones. They relish this opportunity.
Really, you had to push him out of bounds. You fucking moron.
16 yards there.
Seriously.
And that'll be good for a Tennessee first.
Wow.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game.
So
get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
Now hold everything. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. So on second down, now whistles and the Raiders are going to signal for a timeout. So the defense had a chance to catch their breath, and now they're back out and ready. And Suckup will put this one right through. And they will take the lead at 13-10. So they kick it through to take the lead. There is a little bit of time left, though, here in the second quarter.
And while they're concerned about not giving up a big return or giving up points themselves going into the half, how good do they feel, though, putting points on the board themselves right near the end of the first half?
And unless this is a quick incompletion, this is likely the last play here of this first half. They'll throw now on the final play. Caught left
holding
side to Crabtree.
On me. Halftime. Most likely. Yep. Hold you. How do I know that?
We
so
have
smart.
Hit halftime. Still. All right. Hang on here. We'll jump
up,
over halftime.
Your stupid commentary.
Let the system
bullshit
and graphics catch up. Okay. All set. Third quarter now.
Fuck him up, guys. Please.
This is taken at the 3. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. And here comes Tennessee as they get set to take the field. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters, as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had ability to see what you've done, they're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace because you are looking for some separation in this ball game.
The adjustment to the adjustment.
Without a doubt. Show them one thing, hit them with something else.
Good job,
dude. And he is going to lose yardage here.
There
it'll
you
be
go.
A loss of a yard, and it'll be 3rd and 10 now. They tried to run the counter, just that the defense wasn't fooled.
And when they're not fooled, you see the end result. Because what you're doing there, you mentioned the counter. You're using your offensive linemen sometimes to pull or move to influence the defensive front to go in that direction.
Nowhere to go.
Get up. Fuck, he and both were coming on that. Matt got there before I got there.
Often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back. Because
if the quarterback,
the ball gets away from him, everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction downfield or moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
He came off that line.
And he uncorks a beauty. Best of the day.
Come on, Mickens. Do something for me, buddy.
Take it in at the 22.
Dang it, just shit. Of course not.
A good return there. Nobody fucking blocking. 17 yards. And the Raiders will take possession. A look at the offense now here, coming back out on the road for their first possession of the second half. They were able to get the stop defensively, and now a chance to turn that into points on the offensive end.
Can you imagine what the grease board looks like at the half? Because that's exactly what they printed up. Stop them on defense, get the ball back for our offense, and go downfield and score some points. Now, the last part remains to be seen, but they got the first part done very well.
Do people use grease boards, or you mean the magic marker boards?
Yeah, those two. Oh, man, for him to be that wide open and drop it.
It wasn't even
open,
you idiot.
Sometimes you have just too much time on your hands, right?
God,
you end up thinking way too much, and your hands get shaky.
And yes, he's a tight end, but that's a catch he should have made. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete.
Good job, man.
And he's got enough for the first across midfield to the 48. Looked like a pretty good safe play right there. No, he's had trouble with the interceptions.
He's fucking coming for me, and I didn't know where he fucking blocking.
So many times we hear quarterbacks and offensive coordinators talk about, in your progression, you're either throwing the touchdown or you're throwing the check down. But earlier in the game, it was touchdown
I just pressed the fucking
or interception.
Button, and
now
he
got to the check down. A nice safe throw
did.
And a good one.
Shit.
They run with Washington. They'll get only a couple down to the 44. The big man, Jarrell Casey, in on the stop. The offense in that middle ground here on third down, third and five.
Crabtree.
Here we go now.
He'll look to throw. Being chased out left. Looking left side. He's got it complete.
He got first. He got first.
5 yards on the pickup. And that's going to bring up a fourth down.
Well, it wasn't a big strike.
No.
A timeout here is taken, and it's taken by the kicking team. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter.
I am not selling for nothing less than that. He must be high.
Feeling like they're not quite in field goal range yet, they're going to
go. I'm in field goal range. I just don't want to kick it.
They come out here in the eye.
I'm going for the fucking.
Here we go now with Olawale. And he's able to get it to the 33. Good enough for a first down. It's a gain of five. And they're able to convert here on fourth and inches. First down and 10
the beast.
Now for the offensive group.
Come on, Washington.
They pitch to Washington. And running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
There's so many things that go into playing the position of linebacker. Some of them are actually subtle. Doing the drill work that you do all the time in practice and carrying it over to the game. Get rid of blockers and get to the ball carrier, knock him down for a loss.
It's a 9-yard pickup on the play, and that'll lead here to a third down. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. They'll turn to the power game at Olawale. And he will have the first before he's brought down right on the chalk of the 20. 5 yards is a big
right
up there
the
as
right
that extends
side.
This drive.
They're not even expecting me to do that.
They'll run it with Olawale. And he'll
he's
get this one
run
down
up
to
the
about
middle
the
every
17.
Time.
Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7.
Good solid gain on first down. About
first
what you'd
down.
Expect from the big guy carrying the ball.
Day. Late tight run. Go back. That's all they got for
just
fullbacks?
Play after
really?
Play after play on this long drive for
that's
the
stupid.
Offense. They come out with one back and 3 tight ends. On the carry, it's Olawale. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3.
He's going
nice
Olawale.
Right
there, right up
the
fucking
face. Sets up a first and goal. looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. Now they'll let Olawale have a crack at her. Only a yard on the pickup there. Second and goal. They'll go with a big back. This is Olawale.
Pushing, he was going back to the line of scrimmage.
And no more. No gain on the play there. They're going to need to come up with something better here on third and goal. Another shot here from the two as they come up on third and goal.
It's the outside of Washington.
Nope. Washington. And this is going to result in losing yardage. They're driven back to the 8-yard line.
Fucking Christ,
dude. Call that a loss of seven.
I'm not getting in the end zone.
They're not
going to
kick it. A chip shot, but they're going for it.
I want the fucking lead. Fuck
down.
The fucking carrier. They're going to do shit for me.
It's a battle for the edges. Who's going to control the edge of the line of scrimmage?
He got it.
We were always taught to keep your outside arm or outside shoulder free.
Fucking
if you were
serious?
playing on the play side, meaning the ball coming towards you. And anyone coming from the backside, pinching down and sliding down towards it to try and keep people kind of locked into one spot. And boy, what a great defensive play there. Worn out leverage, running to the football from the inside out.
Come on, guys, you got to get the safety, please.
And he's back here in the struggle department in this one like he was a week ago. And partner, I think you can pin some of this on that O-line. The room to run, just not
give
there.
Give me a safety, guys, please.
It felt like
do it.
The offensive
line was getting beaten
to the punch by the guys across the ball.
It was pretty evident, I thought.
I mean, they were off the ball fast, penetrating, getting into the offensive backfield.
Really, a lot of runs before they got started.
So I thought your observation
was spot on, and you're right there again this week.
Same thing is happening. Not able to get started because they're not able to
control
the point of attack.
And remember, following the safety, you give the football up as well, and they free kick it from the 20 now. And he'll go ahead and field this at the 5.
That's right. That's what I thought, bitch.
And this will probably be the last play of the quarter.
Now we kick a field goal if we want to.
They go with Washington to begin the drive. Only a couple there as he'll be brought down about the 28. We have played three quarters. We'll return with more after. Back now in Nashville. This one's still anybody's ball game. It's a one-point difference here as we begin the fourth quarter of play.
I got two people are fucking throw to you.
On play action, they'll throw.
Oh, I don't want to do that.
He rifles one incomplete. They were trying to get it to DeAndre Washington, and it's third down. Let's see if the defense tries any pressure here on third and 8. Now they'll run it on the toss.
Nope. I didn't do it.
Now on the play, and that's going to leave him with a fourth down. Here's Marquette King now. On for his second punt. He'd take a repeat of his first. And he gets this away. Look at this. This is a good one. And a bit of a mistake there. This is well into the end zone for a touchback. DeMarco Murray and company heading back onto the field. And we have seen a decline in the numbers. Where does the fault lie? Just him? Maybe the guys up front? Combination?
Well, as you and I both know, it's almost always a collective deal. But in this case, I think maybe the offensive line got a little overconfident. They blocked so well in the first half.
31.
Picked up on what the defense was doing. I think we've seen an adjustment now that they have not picked up on, and now they're being a little bit overwhelmed. Now, that was well defended, and as a cornerback, what you're taught when you see a wide receiver screen, either you get underneath the play before the blocking forms, or you're going to have to fight your way through it by getting through some blocking. That was a really nice play there.
Going right side here, and that's complete. And they're able to get this one across the 35. A good pickup there of 20 yards. And a nice pitch and catch to pick up the reception against man coverage.
Both of them read how much yardage they needed, figured what they had to do, and were able to beat the man coverage for the completion.
Time to ground it out now with Murray. And he takes this up right near the 45-yard line. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave them with a second and two. Well, they'll take that every time with a lead, first down, fourth quarter, getting 8 yards. You love that.
They will take it, and you have to ask the defensive guys, why did you give it? I mean, you know the situation. You're down, have to stop them, have to get the football back. But hey,
off to the races, DeMarco Murray. And he makes it all the way down to the 13-yard line. And early in this one, DeMarco Murray sending a warning note out to the defense that they better start getting him on the ground or it could be a long game.
A dynamic, explosive run. And you're exactly right, partner. If they don't start stopping this right here, right now, look out. He can pile it up in a big way, and that'll really help his team out.
7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
You guys need to get in front of the fucking ball, dude. You're letting him do that.
Partner, and they're able to complete the pass.
Can't let him even catch it, dude, because they're getting first down just by catching the fucking ball. Get in front of the fucking ball like a fucking goddamn man, dude.
Here's Murray. And they'll get him down here at about the 5-yard line. Give him a yard on the run there, and that's going to set up a third down and two.
Is making them gain unnecessary yards that they shouldn't be getting.
Green, 39. Green.
They'll go to the air here on third and two.
Oh, what?
And that is incomplete. Tajay Sharp, the intended target, and it's fourth down. So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. From the left hash, a chip shot here. And Succop will put this one right through, and that'll move their lead up to four now. So they get the three here, but you wonder whether that's going to be enough.
Yeah, I mean, you've now made it so they need a touchdown rather than a field goal to catch them. But you're right. If they'd gotten six out of that drive, this would be a much different game.
This is taken just shy of the 10 here. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. Now the Raiders offense, they get set to head back on the field. They'll start the drive with Washington. And he'll get about three here as he's out to the 30.
Thing is, but
they certainly got
dented
with that first down run.
What,
so now they've got to be back on their heels a little bit as a defense.
6 yards here to go for the offense on second down. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw.
Nobody fucking blocking.
Taken down. The safety blitz turns out to be a great call defensively as they sack him for a loss of 9.
You don't fucking block. That's what fucking happens, you fucking dumb niggers.
Faking pass. Oh my god. Under pressure and they got
you. Happens
again.
A fucking game because you're a dumb fucking nigger.
He's the one to get in this
stupid,
time.
Dude.
And
he's a fucking dickhead. I'm tired of this shit.
A fourth down.
Brandon, what I remember most about playing with guys who knew how to rush the passer, they would just tell you, just cover people for me, just long enough for me to get there. And that's exactly what happened on that play.
And that one hits at the 7, but bounds into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback.
Can't fucking do anything. You're not going to block.
The Titans offense now, they get set to head back out here. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased
that
they didn't punch it in for 6 points.
Possible.
But they also have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
Ridiculous. You're a bitch, dude. Punt the fucking ball. You're such a pussy. Such a fucking pussy. Bitch ass castle.
Time for a break. We'll come back, see what transpires after this.
What the fuck up? God,
so the Titans in possession of the football here as we get you reset. They've got a second down now as they search for a way to get this one to the finish line.
Let's see what happens in 2 minutes.
Carries piling up. It's Murray again.
Wow.
Well, that one will get him halfway to the first down marker. 7 yards makes it third and 7 now.
Boy, where would these guys be without his performance on the ground? That puts him over 100 yards now for the afternoon, and I tell you, he seems to be getting stronger as the day goes on.
They go with Curry again.
And he'll walk. Now the Raiders are going to use another timeout here. That'll be their second, so one more chance to stop the clock here, and we'll be back.
Come on, Mickens, do something here. Come on, baby.
He gets this one away, and boy, it's another
shitty
boomer.
Kick. Go right.
Taking
hard
it about
right.
The 36.
Oh,
8 yards on the return following a punt of 41. And possession will switch hands, first and 10.
He had it.
Now the Oakland
fucking dumb blocker got fucking
away. God. Down here in a one score game, but the time gets a factor, but it's not a huge factor right now, is it?
It's really not, because this amount of time gives them a chance to
push
run their
me,
offense, to go through play sequences. And this is what they work on every week in practice, usually on a Friday. They go over this type of a situation, late game situation. What are we going to do when we have the opportunity? They've called these plays a bunch of times.
Ooh, that was dangerous.
Well, they have the opportunity now. Here's the
execution.
I think that's a big time play there, because the slant route is really hard to cover because the timing is so quick. But able to see it, diagnose it, and get to the football. That's why he was able to bat it away.
Washington on third and short.
Got it.
He has the first down yardage before they bring him down right at the 45. And they're going to speed things up here.
Come on. Hurry the fuck up.
He's back to throw. They'll roll him out right. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete.
I like the boldness, and I like that they took a shot downfield, but it was well covered, and he was able to get a hand in and knock it away.
So they're still at the original line of scrimmage here. Second down and 10. Back to throw. Oh,
what the fuck is fucking blocking, you fucking fat asses?
We're going to get a timeout here.
Seriously.
That'll be their third and final stoppage here as we step
aside. I'm just going to go right fucking past him and let him fuck. You're such a fucking idiot. Who the fuck was that? I'm letting him go. Where the fuck was that? I'm letting him go. It's done. I'm done with that. Nope. He's gone. Who's the fat fuck that missed him? Rodney Hudson. You're gone. I don't give a fuck how long you've been there. You're gone. You're a pathetic.
Third down, 15 yards
you
still
just
needed.
Cost us that bullshit. Fuck off. You're done. I'm done with that. We just
back
fucked up
throw.
Everything.
Now they set up the screen. That's complete. And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. Down four late. Gotta go for it here on fourth down.
Game over.
Well, going into the final play.